it's this that I've stumbled across. Oh, you're not going to fool me that easily. I know a mortal when I see one. To you, a god can look like anything they want, even like one of you. But a god's eyes are different. You don't have a divine aura. Besides, gods never take a form that small unless they're in the mortal world. And I'm equally certain that you're not supposed to be here in the land of the gods. We'd all know if a mortal had been allowed to enter for the first time in centuries. That makes you, my little friend, a trespasser. Now, why would a mortal sneak their way in here, It was certainly no accident. You must be some mixture of talented, well-connected, and fortunate to have made it past the guardians and through the gate. You must have some sort of compelling goal. Come to spirit away some divine treasure. To meet one of us in person. Or perhaps you're only passing through here on the way to the underworld to retrieve the soul of a loved one. Oh, that's precious. Too frightened to speak. That's all right. It's not as if any answer you gave us would justify your presence. The land of the gods is utterly forbidden to mortals under all circumstances. And the question is, what do I do with you? I'm supposed to strike you down. Or alert the guardians. But that doesn't seem very fun now, does it? A mortal defying the odds to enter the forbidden land, only to be killed like vermin. That's far too sad of a story. On the other hand, I don't really want to just let you go. You'll surely be caught by someone else with more respect for the rules and be killed anyway. We should do something more fun. I think I'll take you home with me. A god's temple is his own domain, not subject to any laws but his own. Once you're home with me, you'll be safe. Nobody can harm you there without my permission. Well, you are most welcome, little mortal. Although, I think you perhaps do not understand my intentions. I intend to use you for my own entertainment. I am Stellabris, god of stars. Mortals are, by far, the best entertainment for the gods. But my domain doesn't allow me to set foot in the mortal world often. When I descend the world, stars begin to fall from the sky. Even if I were to descend the mortal world, we are forbidden to steal away mortals for our own use. So for me to come across a mortal here, so deliciously unprotected, well, I'd be a fool not to take advantage. Oh dear. Well, it is a mortal's nature to beg and plead. But you really should not bother. If I don't take you with me, then I'm better off killing you. I might get in trouble if they find that I let you go. But nobody can protest what happens within my own temple. You'd rather stay alive, wouldn't you? If anything, you should be delighted to have the privilege of living in a god's temple. You cannot imagine how perfect everything is in my home. Never-ending food, music, and all manner of delights. And for a little thing like you, it's practically the size of a city. Usually, a mortal has to sacrifice in order to do their duty and please the gods. But just think, you could serve me by having your life saved and being taken to a place of happiness. It would be madness to ask for more. Disc, disc, disc. And yet, you don't look reassured. Are you truly so attached to your life of suffering and hardship that you cannot bear to leave it? Ah, of course. I'd almost forgotten. You came to the land of the gods for a reason. What is it that drives you to enter forbidden lands and refuse a god's blessing? That's precious, but also hardly necessary anymore. Oh, you cannot fool me. You mortals are all the same in very particular ways. You say you want to end the drought your people suffer, but do you really? Is that what you in particular want? You cannot lie to me. Mortals are always self-serving, just like the gods. You just don't feel comfortable admitting it. What you want is fame. Why else would you go on such a grand, arduous quest? You picked the most daring, thrilling option to save your people, because you want them to sing about it for generations. You don't need that anymore, though. center of attention. To your heart's content. In my temple. I'll have gods and goddesses visiting from all over to see you. And you can enjoy their attention along with an easy life. All you need to do to earn praise and comfort is play games all day. Mortals are the best because we cannot anticipate how you'll act. You don't make all the right decisions like we do. You do foolish, unpredictable things that make you endlessly fascinating to watch. You do not seem to understand the position you are in. I'm not trying to convince you because I need your permission to bring you home. I just do not want you to do something foolish, like make a lot of noise or try to escape. I'd like to bring you back without incident. You don't have a choice in the matter. You're coming back with me, whether you like it or not. But I'll be a lot more comfortable if you tell me you want to come. It will make everything go so much smoother. I won't have any need to bind and silence you. It would be a shame to start off on such an unpleasant note. Just let this be the wonderful, joyous day that it is. The day that you earned God's favor and won a lifetime of happiness. As for your people, well, what do they matter, really? You could end the drought, somehow, but it would hardly make a real difference. If they don't die of thirst, then they'll only die from hunger or disease. Or war. The very best possibility is death by old age. Why fight so hard just so they can suffer longer and then die anyway? You have a chance to change your situation in a meaningful way. Just take it. So naive. Still, it's endearing in a way. Alright, let's try this a different way. As it happens, I'm probably largely to blame for the drought. Well, you see, my power lies in the night sky, and when the clouds shroud the sky, my power weakens. So me and my friend, who rules over the daytime sky, used our combined might to overpower the god of clouds. His nasty little puffballs are becoming rarer and rarer, and it has allowed us to remain at full power all the time. Still your anger for a moment. It won't do you any good to threaten me. You can't do anything to harm me anyway. Listen to what I have to say. Your best chance now is to convince me to change my mind. It's not likely, but it's not as though there's never been a mortal who changed a god's mind. And you only get that chance if you come with me to my temple. There, you see. You can pretend to serve your people and come live with me. A win-win for both of us. Now you're getting it. And if you somehow convince me, you can spend the rest of your life enjoying my temple with the satisfaction of knowing you helped your people. If you insist that you actually care about them, allow me to just pick you up and stow you in my tunic. It wouldn't do for you to be spotted before we get home. Can you see from inside there? I'd hate for you to miss the view of my temple from the outside. Good. Just to make extra certain you aren't seen, I'll fly us there. You can get a good look at the many temples the gods live in from here. Each and every one is an expression of that particular god. Like that one. That belongs to the goddess of the ocean. You could probably guess that from the fact that it's half submerged in water. Oh, but the one you should be looking at is over there. See? Ah, I love it so. The countless floating islands represents the myriad of stars in the sky. It's even more spectacular at night when it starts to glow. The whole thing sparkles and shimmers beautifully. And it's your home from now on. I can sense your resentment. You must still be upset with me for my hand in the drought. But we'll see how you feel after you settle in. I think you'll find it hard to hate your benefactor when you realize just how spectacular of a life you are going to live.